Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you a quick technique to transform your ordinary photos into compelling color images. Open a photo you'd like to use. Go to Image, Mode, and Grayscale. If you see this message, click Discard. Go back to Image, Mode, and Duotone. Keep in mind, only 8-bit grayscale images can be converted to duotones. The Duotone Options window will open. You can choose Duotone, Tritone, or Quad Tone. For this example, I'll choose Quad Tone. By clicking on the boxes, you can change the colors. Just set them in descending order, darkest at the top and lightest at the bottom. Once you pick the colors, Photoshop will ask you to name them in these fields. The blue color I picked is 002AFF, and the aqua color is 00FFF0. When you're happy with your colors, click OK. Go back to Image, Mode, and revert it back to RGB color. To brighten your image, open your Levels window by pressing Ctrl-L on Windows or Command-L on a Mac. Slide the input white to the left until your image looks good to you. Make 3 copies of your image by pressing Ctrl or Command-J 3 times. Click on the bottom layer to make it active, and click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer above it. We'll fill it with white. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, click the small double box icon or press the letter D on your keyboard. Since white is the background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete to fill the empty layer with white. Hide the top 2 layers and make layer 1 active. Reduce its opacity to 70%. Make the layer above it active and visible. We'll create a soft dark vignette around the edges. Go to Filter and Lens Correction. The Lens Correction window will open. Click Custom and slide the vignette amount all the way to the left. Then click OK. If you have a version earlier than CS6, go back to Filter, Distort, and Diffuse Glow. If you have CS6 or later, go back to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Distort folder and choose Diffuse Glow. For this photo, I'll keep the graininess 0, the glow amount 3, and the clear amount 10. Since each photo has different characteristics, you may want to experiment with these amounts to achieve similar results as this. Then click OK. Change the blend mode to hard light. Next, we'll blur the outer edges of the photo. Open your brush tool and choose a relatively large brush size. I'm making it 500 pixels with a hardness of 0%. The blend mode is normal, and the opacity and flow are 100%. Press the F5 key to open your brush tip shape panel. Uncheck all the boxes, but smoothing is okay. Press F5 again to close the panel. Press Q to open the quick mask mode, and brush over the part of your photo you want to bring attention to. Press Q again to revert it into a selection, and go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it to an amount that looks good to you. I'll blur it 5 pixels. Make Layer 1 active, and blur it. Blur it 1 pixel. To delete the selection, press Ctrl or Command D. I want the Empire State Building to have a bit less diffuse glow to it, so I'll make the top layer visible and active. I'll click on the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to it. I'll invert the layer mask by pressing Ctrl or Command I. I'll reduce the opacity to 50% and brush once over the building. Have fun transforming your photos into striking, compelling images. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.